Some people call me the space cowboy. Yeah. Some call me the gangster of love. Some people call me Maurice.
Hey, hey, what's going on, fellow Tightwads and fellow Cal Golden Bears fans? Hope everybody's doing well out there on what has been a very wet Sunday out here in the East Bay. Thanks, as always, for all of you tuning in. Thanks again for those of you that came out and joined us over at Laval's on the north side of Berkeley yesterday to watch the Cal-Notre Dame game. And, hey, let's go ahead and get ready to get the 23rd edition of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill underway here on twitch.tv/AceFanRadio. Hope everybody's doing well out there tonight, wherever you happen to be tuning in to catch the shenanigans from. It is the 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad Hill, Keith Salminen, and it's going to be another rendition of the Bear Raid where that 30th governor of Tightwad will be coming at you solo for this entire edition of the podcast. Let's just say that partying, watching the game yesterday, even though Taddy was there with me at the watch party, just not the mood we were in to want to record anything, I guess you could say, after the game was over with, which obviously I'll get into here a little bit more in a bit once we get into recapping stuff with Cal football during tonight's edition of the show. So no Donnie, no Taddy, no Tito. It will be just yours truly coming at you here on this edition of the show. And obviously, we're going to be talking about a lot more than just Cal football here tonight. We'll, of course, be opening up things with the latest with Cal football and what they got on tap between now and when the next edition of the show hits you at the beginning of October. Obviously, also tonight, we're going to check in on things with men's and women's soccer, field hockey, volleyball, men's water polo, cross country, men's and women's golf, men's tennis. And, yeah, that's pretty much what's on the docket for this edition of the show tonight. And then, of course, later on during the final segment, I'll give you a heads up on some of the sports that you'll expect to see and hear about when we come at you for the next edition of the show that have not yet gotten underway. As, of course, the fall programs just been underway a little over a month, I can guess you can say at this point, since some of the programs started early, mid-August. But a lot of the stuff kind of beginning to start up now. Other stuff will be beginning later on in September, beginning of October. And of course, once those other programs get into the mix, we will take a look at what they are up to and have on tap over the course of the remainder of the year on here with this year's editions of the Bear Raid and such. Yeah. On that note, let's go ahead and get things underway here in this first segment of this 23rd edition of this podcast that is, of course, brought to y'all by a 99-year-old pile of dirt that overlooks a college football stadium up in Strawberry Canyon of Berkeley, California. And again, what pretty much has been, you know, the foundation for this podcast when it was first, you know, excuse me, I'm getting all tongue-twisted there, my bad, y'all. Pretty much what's been looked at as the foundation of this show since myself and Taddy first conceived the idea of a Cal-themed, fan-produced podcast, you know, over a decade plus ago. As we, of course, begin tonight's show taking a look at what Cal football has been up to since we came at you last time on September the 4th. Two games played by the Golden Bears since we did that last edition of the show, and obviously a couple games ahead between now and when the next edition of the show goes down, which as of right now is slated for tentatively excuse me, October the 1st. So let's go ahead and begin things obviously with the first of two games that we'll be looking at, one, of course, being the second home game of the year for Cal, and then, of course, the most recent game that happened yesterday, Cal's first road trip of the 2022 season. Cal, of course, opening up the 2022 college football slate of games with back-to-back home games. They, of course, opened up the year with a 34-13 win over UC Davis back on September the 3rd. We, of course, went over that on the last edition of the show. That, of course, set them up for their second game of the year and second home game of the year as well, as the UNLV Running Rebels would come into Strawberry Canyon and face off with the Golden Bears at California Memorial Stadium, while myself and others, of course, for the second time in 2K22, made the ascent up to the 99-year-old Tightwad Hill to watch the game action. Yours truly, of course, actually was a little late getting to this one, as I had obligations with Forever Oakland early in the day that went from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. So basically, Made it up there for the second half of the game. Before I got up there, of course, Cal opened up the contest with a 14-0 shutout of UNLV to open up things in the first quarter of play. UNLV would outscore Cal 7-3 in the second half of this contest, but Cal, of course, still having the lead as they would go up into the half by a lead of 17-7. As mentioned, of course, yours truly getting there just, you know, a few minutes after the second half began up there at Memorial Stadium. And for some reason, once I got there, the California Golden Bear offense decided to go MIA for the entirety of the second half of this contest. For the second quarter in a row, UNLV would outscore Cal 7-3 in the third quarter. Neither team able to put anything up on the board in the final quarter of play. So even though there was plenty of opportunities for the Golden Bears to add on in this one, and because of them not capitalizing on that, that meant there were opportunities for UNLV to actually steal this one, but the Rebels were not able to capitalize on things on their end either. Cal would hold on to a 6-point victory in what would end up being an ugly win, but hey, win's a win nonetheless. Your California Golden Bears defeating the UNLV Rebels last Saturday at California Memorial Stadium by the final of 20-14. You know, yeah, great, you know, well, not going to say a great win, you know, ugly win, definitely by far. Just, again, really annoyed, as many of the others up there on the hill were as well, that this team basically, you know, had the Rebels on the ropes going into the first half, and then just, again, the offense completely shutting the hell down in the second half of the game. Opportunities there, as mentioned, for Cal to put the Rebels away. Never took advantage of it. Luckily for them, UNLV was not able to capitalize on things on their end in the second half outside of that touchdown they scored in the third quarter. So, you know, it easily could have been a situation where Cal could have easily had been looking at a 1-1 record after the second week of the season. But luckily for them, they held out, kept UNLV off the board in the fourth quarter, even while being kept off the board themselves in the fourth quarter, and again holding on to a 6-point W last Saturday in Strawberry Canyon. Leading passer for Cal, by the way, in that one was Jack Plumbers. He was 28 of 39 for 278 yards, one touchdown, and one pick during the contest. He had a long of 37, and he was sacked four times over the course of the game. UNLV's leading passer was Doug Brumfield, who was 18 of 33 for 206 yards. He also threw one touchdown and one pick, had a long of 33, and was sacked three times by the Cal defense over the course of this one. Leading rusher for Cal was Jaden Ott, seven attempts on 53 yards, and had one rushing touchdown with a long of 23 in the contest. Over on the UNLV side of things, Aiden Robbins was their leading rusher on 14 attempts with 85 yards, a long of 31, and he also scored the lone rushing touchdown for UNLV in this contest. Cal's leading receiver was Jeremiah Hunter, 5 receptions for 79 yards, a long of 37. He didn't have a touchdown reception in this contest. Was the case for the majority of the receivers, as the lone touchdown reception that was gained in the air by Cal was by running back Jay Knott, who, of course, had 3 receptions for 16 yards along a 12 and that touchdown. Leading receiver for the Rebels was Ricky White, who had 4 receptions on 59 yards along of 23, no touchdown receptions, while the only touchdown reception overall for the Rebels was courtesy of Kyle Williams, who also on the day had 3 receptions for 52 yards and a long of 33 for the UNLV Rebels. So again, Cal holding on to things barely by the skin of their chinny chin chin as they defeat the Rebels last Saturday in Berkeley by the final of 20-4. And again, just a game where they, you know, could have put UNLV away. UNLV easily could have put us away, too, because of, you know, the offense deciding to go UA in the whole second half of this contest. But end of the day, no matter how ugly that one looked, it ended up being a victory for Cal. So Cal, of course, opening up the year with a 2-0 record. And, of course, that would set things up for the first road game of the year, which, of course, myself, 29th Governor of Tightwad Hill, Tad Dillinger, and Duncan, along with Rally Chicken, by the way, we met up at Laval's over in Berkeley to watch this one. The only Laval's left in Berkeley, I should say, which, of course, is the one on north side. There used to be one on south side up until about 10-plus years ago, and then they closed it for some odd reason, and crazy thing is ever since the south side Laval's closed, they've never been able to really keep anything regularly in that spot. So, yeah, only Laval's left in Berkeley, in case y'all didn't know, is the one over on the north side of the UC Berkeley campus. It's located over on USLID. Definitely appreciate them having us there. Taddy, of course, lives over in the area and is very familiar with the folks that run Laval's. So definitely appreciative of them having us, being able to come over there, host that watch party there yesterday, and potentially could be the new permanent spot for when we decide to hold watch parties for Cal football related stuff, or maybe even other Cal athletic related programs, depending on what they're doing in their respective seasons and whatnot. Our spot used to be Pappy's, but of course Pappy's no longer exists. Still kind of waiting to see ultimately what ends up taking over that spot as time goes on. But I think even regardless of, you know, if they put something new down there or not, I'm satisfied. I like the setup at Laval's. Nice little chill atmosphere. Definitely be great to, you know, bigger games, you know, later in the year, because there's going to be some rivalry matchups that are road contests that we're probably going to look into going over there to watch. Definitely be great to get over there and get some more of our fellow Tightwads and even some of our other fellow Golden Bear fans to come over there and join us. So, yeah, definitely, again, thank you to Laval's for allowing us to set up shop at your longtime establishment on the north side yesterday. And definitely looking forward to this not being the last time that the members of Tightwad Hill gather together and show up to slam on some pizza and a pitcher of Budweiser at your great longtime place during the course of a Cal game. And I mean, it's not the first time I've been there. I'd been to Laval's before, but it's, you know, same, you know, basically about the same amount of time it was up until they had both the North and the South side one open. I forgot if I went there to watch a Cal game or if it was a A's game potentially, but I have been here before. First time in years I've been there. Obviously a little bit of remodeling and changes in there since I last went in there, but kind of basically the same layout, so it was great to go back there, and I'm definitely looking forward to us obviously doing future watch parties for Cal football and, again, potentially other Cal athletic programs there down the road. On that note, let's go ahead now and take a look at what went down during the course of that contest that we watched over there at Laval's on the north side. And many of you out there are probably watching from home, wherever your ABC, NBC provider was. And obviously there are several individuals out there that we know, some folks from Tightwad Hill, others that we know that sit in the stadium, and of course a whole bunch of Cal alumni and others that actually made the trip to South Bend yesterday for that contest against the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Myself and Taddy and a couple of the Tightwads were planning on making that trip, but life got in the way for all of us, so that's why we instead decided to have the watch party for anyone that wasn't going to be going to South Bend over at Laval's yesterday. Game where initially, for the majority of it, you really thought that there was actually a chance that the Golden Bears could pull up an upset against the Fighting Irish. I mean, yeah, Notre Dame going into this one was 0-2, you know, legitimately understandable losing to Ohio State, but losing to Marshall last week? Come on. And the fact that you had, you know, Notre Dame basically relying on their backup quarterback to start against Cal in this one, with their regular starter being out with an injury. Halftime, at least, it did look like potentially the Golden Bears could get the victory before this one would be all said and done. Neither team scored anything in the first quarter, so basically the first 15 minutes of the game were pretty much a defensive stalemate. Cal would end up scoring first. They got a touchdown before Notre Dame would tie it up with a touchdown of their own, and then ultimately Cal would get a field goal as well to go in up at the half by a score of 10-7. Both teams would each get touchdowns in the third quarter, as basically, like I said, three-fourths of the way through this one, you saw Cal going in to the final period up by a field goal and just, you know, obviously play the right moves on defense, you know, try to set yourself up for some touchdowns or maybe even some field goals to add on, and easily you could hold on to this one. Well, some stuff basically ended up happening over the course of the finale of this one. Biggest one, of course, being that questionable offsides call that was called on the Cal defense when Notre Dame missed a field goal at one point. And, you know, even the broadcasters were sitting there pointing it out, and we pointed it out and were furious about it, seeing that while we were at Laval's yesterday. Yeah, no one on the Cal defense jumped off sides on that. Nobody moved until after the ball was snapped. And it's ridiculous even more that you got even the broadcast team out there, which is, you know, obviously because of the deal that's in place, you know, NBC basically is Notre Dame's national, you know, broadcasting channel, pretty much, I guess you could say. But even they were saying that that was a ridiculous call on that one. And, you know, there were some other questionable calls as well, you know, not just in that final quarter of play, but sporadically throughout this one. But, you know, the reality is, all that aside, pretty much almost similar to kind of what happened the week before. I mean, yeah, Cal did get a touchdown in the second half, unlike last week. But again, situation where you had opportunities to put Notre Dame away, you didn't do it. And unlike UNLV the week before, who failed to capitalize on your screw-ups, Notre Dame did capitalize on your miscues and ultimately would regain the lead in the fourth quarter, shut out Cal in the fourth quarter 10-0, and ultimately secure their first victory, the win as of the year, as the Fighting Irish would defeat the Golden Bears yesterday at Notre Dame Stadium in South Bend, Indiana, by the final of 24-17. Again, Notre Dame's first year of the first win of the year as they improved to 1-2 on the year. Cal suffers their first loss of the 2022 season, falling to 2-1 in their final non-conference game of the year. As of course, beginning with next week's matchup, they'll be beginning their Pac-12 portion of the 2022 NCAA football season. Individual stats here real quick. Let me go ahead and pull those up. Leading passer for your Golden Bears was Jack Plummer, who was 16 of 37 for 184 yards, one touchdown pass. He had a long of 33, and he got sacked six times by the Irish in this one. While on Notre Dame side of things, Drew Pine, who of course is their backup QB, he was 17 of 23 for 150 yards. He had two touchdown passes along a 36, and he was sacked only twice during the course of this one out in South Bend. Leading rusher for Cal was DeCarlos Brooks, five attempts on lead running back, I should say, in this one was DeCarlos Brooks, five attempts for 45 yards, along a 24 and no touchdowns. But the overall leading rusher in this one was quarterback Jack Plummer, who had 12 attempts for 81 yards, along a 24. And he actually had a rushing touchdown himself during the course of the contest. Over on the Irish side of things, Audris Estime was their leading rusher, 18 attempts for 76 yards. He had one rushing touchdown and a long of 14 in the contest. Leading receiver for Cal was Jeremiah Hunt, five receptions for 66 yards, a long of 33. No touchdowns caught, the lone touchdown reception being caught by J. Michael Sturdivant, Sturdivant, and that was the lone receiving touchdown for Cal in this one. While over on the Notre Dame side of things, Chris Tree was their leading receiver, five receptions for 44 yards, a long of 21, and a receiving touchdown. Michael Mayer had the other receiving touchdown for Notre Dame in this one on two attempts for 10 yards and a long of four. So again, final score in this one, yet again, a game that Cal easily could have won. They should have won, but you know, lovable losers unfortunately show their ugly faces once again as Cal ends up losing in this contest by the final of 24-7. A lot closer than a lot of us thought it was going to be, because we even thought, even with Notre Dame being 0-2, them using the backup quarterback, you know, this is Notre Dame. And we all thought that there was still the good chance that Cal was going to get smacked around South Bend in this one. Ended up not being the case, but at the end of the day, just, you know, and this is still, again, even with some questionable refereeing calls in this one, the end of the day, this was a winnable game for the Bears, and they failed to capitalize on this one. So just got to shake it off, come back to Berkeley, rest up, get your practice reps in, and of course get ready for the next game day that you have on tap for yourselves, which of course is this upcoming Saturday, September the 24th, up there at California Memorial Stadium, and of course obviously Tightwad Hill if you're like myself and others and are not dummies and save your money and go and watch these games for free. It's of course the homecoming game for your California Golden Bears. They will be hosting the Arizona Wildcats in a contest contest that will kick off at 2:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time up there at Memorial Stadium in Tightwad Hill. For those of you not making it to the area for to either location, either the stadium or the hill to watch this, it will be on the Pac-12 network over on the Boob Tube. And, of course, KGO 810 a.m. is where you can catch it on the radio dial to, of course, hear the final season of the great Joe Starkey calling play-by-play action on the radio. Pre-game tailgate at the Tightwad 50 Club, of course, will begin at approximately 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time for this one on September the 24th, though I'm pretty sure myself, Taddy, and several others will be up there way, well, you know, Taddy will be way up there way before 11 a.m. I'll probably get up there, you know, around the 9, 10 o'clock time frame myself, but there will be folks up there before 11 a.m., but pretty much the official start time for the tailgate at the Tightwad 50 Club will be at 11 a.m. up there on Tightwad Hill, and of course, as mentioned, start time for this one is 2:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Going to obviously be a whole lot different Wildcat team that the Golden Bears will be facing this year than last year. Last year, of course, was a matchup on the road down there where you actually thought Cal would have won it, and then you had a whole COVID issue go down that kind of decimated the roster and affected things, where a really garbage-ass Wildcats team was able to beat the Golden Bears. Now, it's not going to be the same with that. Obviously, you got changes here with Cal, and you got a whole bunch of changes with the Wildcats. You know, basically, the Wildcats, you know, abused the transfer portal, not just with personnel on the player side, but even on the coaching staff side of things, which is probably part of the reasons why the NCAA is going to be looking into changing things with the transfer portal before next year. But yeah, definitely different squads than it was when these two teams met previously. And of course, meeting down in Arizona last year, they'll be, of course, meeting up here in Berkeley this year. Arizona Wildcats versus California Golden Bears, your 2022 homecoming game at California Memorial Stadium, and of course up on Tightwad Hill. That will be on, again, this Saturday, September the 24th, 2:30 p.m. kickoff up there at California Memorial. Those of you, of course, that are coming up to Tightwad Hill, the pregame tailgate of the Tightwad 50 Club will begin at 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. After that, Cal, of course, the next game after that, because they got two games on tap between now and when we do the next edition of the show, of course. After that homecoming match, Cal will head out on the road once again, as they will head up to Gisa Field in Pullman, Washington on Saturday, October the 1st, to face off against the Washington State Cougars. There has not been a start time announced yet for that contest, and obviously that probably will get announced probably sometime either later on in the week this week, or probably this upcoming weekend, or sometime next week. We're all going to have to wait and see what happens with that. But second Pac-12 game, of course, is mentioned now with the three non-conference games out of the way. Pretty much everything the rest of the way out from this point till the end of the year is all Pac-12 play for the California Golden Bears. So they will have their first road game, again, of the Pac-12 portion of the schedule on Saturday, October the 1st, in Pullman, Washington, against the Washington State Cougars. Gisa Field in Pullman, Washington. And again, we'll have to await when the start time will be announced on that contest. We'll go ahead and wait until the next edition of the show yet again to dip into what the Pac-12 standings are. You know, kind of figured wait until they're actually in conference play to get a rough idea of how things are looking, because nobody, as far as I know, you know, maybe a couple have, but my guess is, yeah, let's just wait until the next show to take a look at the conference standings in the Pac-12 as far as things go with football. Overall, at this point in time right now, your California Golden Bears have a 2-1 record. As mentioned, they have not had any conference games yet. Their first one will be next Saturday in Berkeley, of course, when the Wildcats come into town. They're currently on a one-game losing streak. They're undefeated so far in 2022 at California Memorial Stadium. And thus far, they've only played one road game so far earlier in the season, that, of course, being the loss yesterday in South Bend against Notre Dame. Currently 0-1 away from California Memorial early in the season. So again, that wraps up things for this show's edition of Cal Football. Hopefully, looking forward to seeing y'all up at, on Tightwad this upcoming Saturday when the Arizona Wildcats come into town for the homecoming contest. That, of course, concludes things here in the first segment of tonight's show. But we obviously still got two more segments worth of Cal Athletics talk to come your way. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and take our first break of the night. tonight here on show number 23 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. When we come back, we will take a look at what has been going on over the course of the last couple weeks with men's soccer, women's soccer, and field hockey. And, of course, we'll also take a look at what they have on tap next between now and when we come at you in a couple weeks with the 24th edition of the Bear Raid. Don't go anywhere, folks. Show number 23 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill will be coming right back at you here in a bit. Welcome back, fellow Tightwads and fellow California Golden Bear fans, as we continue on down the road here in this wet Sunday in the East Bay and beyond on show number 23 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. It is the 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad Hill, Keith Salminen, coming at you solo yet again for this edition of the broadcast as yet again no Donnie Knucklehead, no 29th governor of Tightwad Hill, Tad Dillinger III, and no Tito Sochild, as yet again they got stuff going on, and that again is why instead of doing this show at 3 p.m., that's why I got moved to 8 p.m. And as I've mentioned, but I'll go ahead and reiterate in case you know y'all haven't tuned in for a while or you just happen to miss stuff and forget it, because I know especially in this day and age it's kind of really easy at times to forget even small little details and stuff because of, you know, still dealing with COVID and all sorts of other crap going on this planet that is this third orbiting rock from the sun. Usually pretty much if it's just going to be yours truly hosting the Bear Raid, then expect the broadcast usually be moved from 3 p.m. to 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on Sundays. Now, that's not to say that maybe, depending on how I'm feeling and what's been going on, that I might decide that even if it's just me, that I might still do the show at the normal time. You know, just easier for me if, you know, when I'm just doing it by myself, to do it more in that 8 to 10 or, you know, earlier time slot that I'm accustomed to from, you know, all my years of doing A's fan radio. So, yeah, just to reiterate, if it's more than myself hosting the show, then we will usually keep to and try to stick to our traditional 3 p.m. Start time for the broadcast. But, again, if it's just me, then expect them more often than not unless I decide otherwise to be at 8 p.m. when it's just me here. And on that note, let's go ahead and continue on with recapping the last 2 weeks' worth of California Golden Bears athletic action and obviously seeing what the Cal athletic programs that are currently playing at this point in time have on tap between now and the next time we come at you here on the Bear Raid. We, of course, open up things with what Cal football have been up to since the last time we came at you and what they got over the course of the next couple weeks. So let's go ahead and see let's go ahead and take a look at for the first time tonight at what the rest of the Cal athletic world that is going down in the fall, that at least for the sports that have gotten underway at this point in time have going on. So we begin that, of course, with taking a look at some football action as we see what the men's and women's soccer programs at UC Berkeley have been up to since the last time we came at you. We'll go ahead and begin with the men's soccer program over there at Cal. Trying to remember if we recap this one. I want to say potentially, I think both for this and the women's game, they didn't have scores up because they were night games and were going on roughly at the same time that we were doing the Bear Raid. So in the case of the soccer teams, will be going back to September the 4th to see what they have been up to. Back on September the 4th, they, of course, had a matchup on the road against UC San Diego down at Triton Soccer Stadium in La Jolla, California. That, of course, ended up being a 1-1 draw with the Tritons down there in La Jolla. So neither team getting a W in that one. Cal and UC San Diego playing to a 1-1 draw back on September the 4th. Next contest for Cal men's soccer after that would be on September the 10th as they would face off against California Baptist at Edwards Stadium in Berkeley, California. The Bears would get the W in that matchup as all they would need is one goal when it was all said and done. And it was an early birthday present for one of the individuals on the team, too, as your California Golden Bears shut out California Baptist on September the 10th in Berkeley by the final of 1-0. Next contest for them after that came a little over 5 days later on Thursday, September the 15th, as they would yet again be at home for a match on the pitch at Edwards Stadium in Berkeley. This time the Golden Bears playing host to the San Diego State Aztecs, and Cal would win yet again as they would shut out San Diego State in this one back on the 15th by the final of 2-0. Cal, of course, would look to stretch that to a three-game win streak as 3 days after defeating San Diego State, they would host UCLA in Berkeley, so three consecutive home games for your California Golden Bears up to this point. And this was actually a contest that took place earlier today in Berkeley, and unfortunately, Cal not able to get their third consecutive victory as the UCLA Bruins would actually defeat the Cal men's soccer team in Berkeley today by the final of 2-1. Upcoming contests for your California Golden Bears men's soccer program between now and the next time we come at you on the Bear Raid on October the 1st. They'll have two matchups that will go down between now and then. Another game actually being played in Berkeley, so they've had four consecutive or will have played four consecutive home games by the next time they come out on the pitch. And that, of course, will be on Sunday, September the 25th, as St. Mary's will be coming in to Berkeley to face off with the California Golden Bears in a 1 p.m. match on the pitch at Edwards Stadium in Berkeley, California. After that, they will have one road game that will go down on September the 29th. It will be across the peninsula at Leonard Q. Kagan Stadium at Stanford, California. Yep, you're already know the men's soccer program from Cal is going to take on the Ferd over there in Stanford on September the 29th, road game for the Golden Bears, and that matchup with Stanford will begin at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So two games for Cal men's soccer between now and the next time we come at you. Home game at Edwards on September the 25th against St. Mary's, and then a road game across the peninsula to face off with Stanford at Stanford in an 8 p.m. matchup at Leonard Q. Kagan Stadium over there in Stanford. Current record for the Cal men's soccer program early on here in the 2022 season, they have an overall record of 2-2-3. That, of course, would be two wins, two losses, and three draws, ties, however you want to call it. I know the preferred professional reference for most in soccer is to refer to them as draws. So, yeah, two wins, two losses, and three draws so far here for the men's soccer program. They are 1-1 so far in Pac-12 conference play. Currently, of course, sitting on a one-game losing streak after they lost UCLA earlier in the day today. So far this year, they are 2-1-1 when they play at Edwards Stadium. When they're playing away from Edwards right now, they have a record of 0-1-2 on the road. So that concludes coverage here on this one for men's soccer. Again, two upcoming games for them between now and the next time we come at you. Of course, as a reminder, home game on Sunday, September the 25th at 1 p.m. at Edwards Stadium against St. Mary's, and then again a road game at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time at Leonard Q. Kagan Stadium at Stanford on September the 29th when they play a road matchup against the Stanford Cardinal. We're going to go ahead and obviously stick to soccer or football for those of you out there that, of course, feel that this is the real true football and what the we covered early in the first segment of the show was American football. But let's go ahead and move, obviously, from what the men's program has been up to and check out what the women's soccer program has been up to since the last time we hit you all upside the head here on the Bear Raid. Same thing that we did for the men's program. We'll go ahead and piggyback to the women's program's game on September the 4th, because I want to say, if I remember correctly, these were games that basically had started just roughly before or around the time frame that we started our broadcast, and they didn't have, you know, anything up there. And kind of pretty much the same thing happened for the women's team that happened for the men's team. The women's team was playing, though, in Berkeley on Sunday, September the 4th, and they were hosting 14th-ranked Pepperdine at Edwards Stadium for that one. Contest that ended in a 1-1 draw for the Lady Golden Bears in that one. Their next match after that would be on Thursday, September the 8th. That would be a road contest to Titan Stadium in in Fullerton, California, to take on Cal State Fullerton for the second consecutive match in a row. The Cal Lady Golden Bears would play to a draw, as this one would end in a nothing draw between Cal and Cal State Fullerton. The Lady Golden Bears would stay on the road for another matchup that would go down a couple days later on Sunday, September the 11th, as they would head into Buckshaw Stadium in Santa Clara to take on Santa Clara. Cal would find themselves back on the winning side of things as they would shut out Santa Clara by the final of 1-0 back on September the 11th. 4 days later, they would head out to the godforsaken wasteland of a desert that's Las Vegas, Nevada, as they would face off with UNLV at Peter Johanna Soccer Field, and Cal would pick up yet another victory in that one as they would defeat the Lady Rebels by the final of 2-0. And of course, their most recent matchup happening today in Berkeley, California, over at Edwards Stadium over on the UC Berkeley campus, is Pennsylvania was in town to take on the Cal Lady Golden Bears on the football pitch, and it was another victory for Cal women's soccer as they shut out Pennsylvania today at Edwards Stadium by the final of 3-0. Upcoming matches for Cal women's soccer. They have three games that will be going down between now and when our next edition of the Bear Raid comes at you on October the 2nd. They have a road match that, of course, will be down in SoCal a couple days from now on Friday, September the 23rd at Wallace Annenberg Stadium in Los Angeles. They will face off against UCLA at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. There will be another road game after that as Cal will be heading out to Sun Devil Soccer Stadium in Tempe, Arizona on Thursday, September the 29th for a road match against the Arizona State Sun Devils. That one will start at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And the next time that we, of course, do the Bear Raid, maybe at 3 p.m. on October the 2nd, could be at 8 p.m. if it ends up being just myself here. At some point, either 3 hours or 8 hours before the next show, Cal will be on the road still for another road match. They will stay in Arizona. They will just head to Tucson, of course, to Murphy Field at McCallany Soccer Stadium as they will face off with the Lady Arizona Wildcats in that one. Cal women's soccer currently overall has a record of 5 wins, 1 loss, and 3 draws. They have not yet had a conference game thus far here in their early 2022 schedule. They are 2-0-1 playing at Edwards Stadium this year on the road so far. They have a record of 3-1-2 away from Edwards Stadium. So women's soccer program doing pretty decently and off to a good start right now. Men's program kind of, you know, a little bit middle on par, but showing signs that maybe they can obviously, you know, do things here. We're going to have to wait and see, obviously, how both of these programs end up faring and going as the 2022 fall sports programs go on. We'll go ahead and stick with the Lady Golden Bears side of things in this one, but moving off of the pitch now, we will go ahead and take a look at what Cal Field Hockey has been up to since the last time we came at you, and of course, what they have on tap between today and the next time we come at you. We'll go ahead and just same thing with them. They also were playing on Sunday, September the 4th. So just to cover our butts, you can say we'll go ahead and recap their game action from September the 4th through today as well. They, of course, back on September the 4th, were playing a home game at Underhill Field in Berkeley, California, against the University of Indiana, a game that they actually ended up losing by the final of 3-2 in overtime. Next match for them after that, they would stay at Underhill Field, in Berkeley, California, for a matchup that would go down on Friday, September the 9th, as number 2 North Carolina would come into town and shut out Cal Field Hockey in that one by the final of 7-0. Next one for that, of course, for the Cal Field Hockey team would be another home game at Underhill Field in Berkeley, California. Number 18 Wake Forest coming in to match up with them back on Sunday, September the 11th. And for the third time in a row, the Cal Field Hockey team would end up taking an L at Underhill Field as Wake Forest would defeat them in that contest on September the 11th by the final of 6-1. Been a while, actually, since then. They haven't played a game in 7 days, and they won't have another set of games on tap until Friday, September the 23rd, when they head into Albany, New York, to take on Albany at Alumni Turf for a 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time match. After that, they will be in Providence, Rhode Island at Lennon Family Field to battle against Bryant on Sunday, September the 25th. That will be a 9 a.m. Pacific Standard Time start. They will then come back to Berkeley, California for a home match at Underhill Field on Friday, September the 30th at a 6 p.m. contest against UC Davis. And that, of course, will be the most recent game for them when we recap those couple games for them on the next edition of the Bear Raid in October. So that wraps up Cal Field Hockey for this one. But that, of course, does not mean that the show is over with, as we still got a couple more sports to cover for y'all before this night is over with. We come back, we'll go and take a look at what Cal Volleyball, Cal Men's Water Polo, and Cal Cross Country have been up to. And, of course, before the night's over with, we also will take a look at men's golf, women's golf, and, hey, men's tennis will be popping up on the program for the first time this season on the show. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back at you here in a bit on show number 23 of the Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill. Welcome back, ladies and gents, bears and cubbies, wherever you are tuning in from on this wet Sunday in Berkeley, the East Bay, and beyond. We're, of course, coming at you, as always, from Dub 6 Studios, which is located in the Eastmont Hills of Oakland, California, the broadcasting HQ and home of our sister podcast and the flagship podcast on this Twitch channel, A's Fan Radio. But this, of course, is not A's Fan Radio. This is show number 23 of the Bear Raid, presented by Tightwad Hill, which, of course, is a Cal fan produced podcast dedicated to covering Cal sports from the fans' perspective in regards to Cal athletics at UC Berkeley in Berkeley, California. It is, of course, the 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad, Keith Salminen, coming at you solo yet again for another fine rendition of this one, not joined by Donnie Knucklehead Hudson, Tad Dillinger III, or Tito Soulchild, as once again they all got who knows what going on in their lives at this point in time. But, of course, we'll try, when we go up to Tightwad the next couple weeks, to get some audio with their takes on the Arizona game, so that way we can get them on here finally during this course, this year's fall portions of the Bear Raid broadcasts. Other than that, yeah, it might be a while before we get Donnie out here. I know Donnie's still trying to settle into a new spot that he's been living after the last couple of months after, of course, things went south with his ex, and they're no longer at the Concord Cottage, which kind of sucks. I was actually looking forward to going back to the Concord Cottage at one point and maybe doing a show, but yep, I guess we'll have to wait until things are settled in and good to go, maybe to go do something in Concord or his other spot, or, you know, who knows? And, you know, hey, maybe I should look into once in a blue moon, maybe seeing if we can take this bad boy over to Laval's, you know. But if I'm going to do that, I'm going to want Donnie and somebody to be there with me. I'm not going to want to just show up at Laval's and host this thing by myself. I mean, if I have to, I will. You know, it wouldn't be the first time. I did it multiple times for years doing A's Fan Radio. But just like with A's Fan Radio, I prefer having my castmates here to bounce off of them. But nights like this, obviously, don't have the luxury of that, and it is what it is. You just got to work with what you got on tap. On that note, we still got two more segments worth of Cal Athletics sports action to go over here with y'all tonight. A couple sports, obviously, that we've already touched basis on since last time we came at you, and then we get into the final segment tonight. We do have at least one sport that we'll be talking about for the first time here in the fall of 2022 that we had not yet discussed on the previous show because it hadn't started yet at that point in time. We'll get more into that, obviously, when we head on in to the final break. But let's go ahead and move on here down the road with Cal Athletics action as we check in with what the Cal Volleyball program has been up to since the last time we came at you. And what, of course, they will have on tap after today leading up to the next time we come at you here on the Bear Raid. They basically had not played prior to the last time we came at you here on the show. They had a couple matches that went down early with their season, of course, beginning back on August the 26th. They were one of the couple sports programs from Cal that actually started either early, middle, or near the end of August. But up until what was it? I guess that, you know, yeah, they hadn't played yet. Their last game was 2 days prior to the last edition of the show. They have had a decent amount of matches, it looks like, since then. But after that most recent match for them when we last came at you, which, of course, was a 3-0 shutout of Northern Arizona on September the 2nd, which was a Friday, they would not play again until 1 week later on a Friday, September the 9th, to be exact, at the Haas Pavilion in Berkeley, California, as Utah Tech came in the face-off against Cal Volleyball. And Cal Volleyball would get their second consecutive win as they would defeat Utah Tech at the Haas by the final of 3-1 back on September the 9th. They would have a second game that Friday, September the 9th, as well, as Tennessee State would face off with them after that 3-1 win over Utah Tech. And it would be yet another win for Cal Volleyball as they would shut out Tennessee State in the second game that went down on Friday, September the 9th, by the final of 3-0. They would be back in action in Berkeley the very next day on Saturday, September the 10th, as they would face off against the University of Nevada. They were trying to seek a fourth consecutive win in that one. Would not be the case, though, as Nevada Volleyball would defeat Cal Volleyball at the Haas Pavilion on September the 10th by the final of 3-1. They would find themselves back on the winning ways, though, after that, as they would head out on a road game trip to Moraga, California on Thursday, September the 15th, in a contest in which Cal Volleyball would shut out St. Mary's Volleyball on the road by the final of 3-0. And their most recent match went down yesterday at the Haas Pavilion in Berkeley, California, as UC Davis came in the face-off with them. Cal Volleyball getting a second consecutive W after that loss against Nevada. After they shut out St. Mary's on September the 15th, they would get a one-point win over UC Davis yesterday at the Haas Pavilion, winning by the final of 3-2. A couple matches on tap for Cal Volleyball between now and when show number 24, the Bear Raid, goes down on Sunday, October the 2nd. A couple days from now, they will be hosting Stanford at an 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time match that, of course, will be at the Haas Pavilion in Berkeley, California. Again, Stanford versus Cal Volleyball at the Haas Pavilion, 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on Wednesday, September the 21st. Road trip for them after that is on Friday, September the 23rd. They will head up to Gill Coliseum in Corvallis, Oregon to take on the Oregon State Beavers. That match will begin at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. They will then come back to Berkeley 7 nights later for a 7 p.m. match against the Washington State Cougars that will take place at the Haas Pavilion on Friday, September the 30th. And then they, of course, will have a match at the Haas Pavilion on the same day that we come at you with the next edition of the Bear Raid. That match at the Haas Pavilion will take place at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time as they will be hosting the Washington Cougars in Berkeley on that day. Cal Volleyball currently at this point in time has a record of 7-3. They have not yet had any conference matches. They're currently riding a 2-game win streak at this point in time. They're 3-1 at the Haas Pavilion so far this year. They're 2-1 away from the Haas Pavilion, and they've had a couple neutral site matches so far this year, and in those contests, they have a record of 2-1, and that will wrap up things for Cal Volleyball on this one. Let's go and go to some aquatic sports action and check out what Cal men's water polo has been up to since the last time we came at you here on the show, and of course as well with them as we've so far done with all the programs on here. Take a look at what they have on tap between now and October the 2nd when the next edition of the Bear Raid comes y'all's way. They last, of course, had matchups go down on Sunday, September the 4th. Those were matchups that took place in Annapolis, Maryland, excuse me. Princeton matched up with Cal Water Polo on September the 4th, and Cal beat them 27-7. They also faced off with Navy that day as well, and they won by the final of 24-8. I feel like I did recap those two matchups back on the last edition of the Bear Raid, but hey, just in case, cover my own butt, just to be on the safe side. After those two matches on Friday, September the 4th, Cal men's water polo would find themselves back in Berkeley at the Spiker Aquatic Complex in a matchup against Pacific that would see them get a victory in overtime over Pacific by the final of 16-15. They would continue to ride out their winning ways after that, as they would stay in Berkeley for a matchup the very next day on Saturday, September the 10th, hosting UC San Diego at the Spiker Aquatic Complex and defeating them as well by the final of 19-15. Another home match in Berkeley for Cal Men's Water Polo at the Spiker Aquatics Complex on Sunday, September the 11th. And hey, they kept the winning ways going, this time defeating Pepperdine Water Polo by the final of 17-12. A couple nights after that, they would face off yet again in Berkeley against UC Irvine in a matchup that again also took place at the Spiker Aquatic Complex over there in Berkeley. And yet again, Cal Men's Water Polo getting yet another victory, defeating UC Irvine in that one by the final of 18-10. Upcoming matchups for them between now and when the next edition of the Bear Raid goes down. They got a few on tap. They will face off against Pomona Pitzer at the Avery Aquatic Center at Stanford, California this upcoming Friday, September the 23rd. That will be at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. They will also be a part of the MPSF invite that will go down over at the very same Avery Aquatic Center in Stanford that they'll be playing on September the 23rd. That MPSF invite will be going down from Saturday, September the 24th through Sunday, September the 25th, and has not yet shown who their opponents will be for that, so we'll have to wait and obviously recap those matches on the next edition of the show. And speaking of which, their next match that will go down before the next edition of the Bear Raid is on the same day as the next edition of the Bear Raid. That will, of course, be a road trip down to the UCSB campus pool in Santa Barbara, California, a road game for Cal against UC Santa Barbara, as Cal Men's Water Polo will face off with them in that one in Santa Barbara at 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Cal Men's Water Polo currently is undefeated so far in 2022. They have an 8-0 record at this point in time. They have not yet had any conference matches yet themselves. 8-game win streak. They're undefeated at home, 4-0 right now at the Spiker Aquatic Complex in Berkeley. Haven't had an actual road set of matches yet at this point in time. So the other four of those 8 wins for Cal Men's Water Polo have been in neutral site contests where they are 4-0 as well. So nice, solid start so far for Cal Men's Water Polo. Definitely interesting to see if they can keep that going. Now, of course, obviously, you would love to see them, you know, any of the programs, you know, regardless what it is, go undefeated or have a decent, solid run. So definitely, hey, Men's Water Polo may not be something that some of you all out there might follow regularly, but hey, you know, they keep doing stuff like that. That's just another national title they can potentially add. And I want to say that they were previous national title holders and are part of, you know, what's contributed to the 100 titles that Cal has won in its existence. So, yeah, hey, may not be a sport, again, that some of you out there may follow regularly, but, hey, it's a sports program at UC Berkeley that's undefeated so far in the fall of 2022. Let's go ahead, and this will be the last sport that we cover for this segment of the show before we take our final break of the night. Going to go ahead and check in on what the cross-country program has been up to since the last time we came at y'all here on the show. And they only had one meet that went down before we joined y'all previously, and that, of course, we covered that meet already. That was the USF Invitational that went down on Saturday, September the 3rd. And they've only had one meet again since then go down, and that was, of course, the UCR Invitational that went down yesterday, Saturday, September the 17th, down in Riverside, California. The men's cross-country team placing 16th in that invitational, while the women's cross-country team ended up placing 18th in that matchup. And it's going to be a while before cross-country does anything else after that. The next time that they will be doing anything, it's going to be a hot while. In fact, we probably won't even touch bases on that until we come at you with the next edition of the Bear Raid. So, yeah, only one trip and match so far for the cross-country program since the last time we came at you. And, of course, we will see what they have on tap 2 weeks from now, because they got nothing going on basically between now and October the 15th. So we'll wait until October the 2nd to tell you what they have on tap with Cal Cross Country. That, of course, means, hey, it is time for the final break of the night here on show number 23 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. We still got three more sports to cover before we wrap things up here on tonight's edition of the show, as we're going to go and take a look at what men's golf and women's golf has been up to. And, of course, for the first time this year, or by this year, I mean obviously for the first time during the fall of 2022 on these editions of the Bear Raid, we'll be checking in on what men's tennis has started up to so far as they began play after the last edition of the show. And there's obviously a couple sports that will be coming up here soon as well that haven't started yet, but will have started or will be starting around the time we do our next edition of the Bear Raid. So obviously, after we check in with those final three sports that have gone down as of late, we'll give you a heads up on what sports will be joining the recaps and preview segments when we come at you the next time here on the Bear Raid. So don't go anywhere, or if you need to, go to the fridge real quick, get a joint rolled up, you know, whatever it is you're doing while you're sitting back listening to yours truly ramble about Cal athletics, because it is the final break on tonight's edition of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill, getting ready to hit you upside the head. We come back from that final break, again, men's golf, women's golf, men's tennis, what we will be covering on the next edition of the show, and of course, my final thoughts of the night before I cut y'all loose for the evening. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back at you here in a bit following the final break on tonight's edition of this podcast that's brought to you by a 99-year-old pile of dirt overlooking a college football stadium in Berkeley, California. We'll be right back at you in a bit for the final segment of show number 23 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. All right, fellow Tightwads, fellow Cal Golden Bears fans, let's go ahead and get this final segment out of the way and get you all cleared out and off to whatever the hell you got planned for the rest of your Sunday night in Berkeley, East Bay, beyond, wherever you were tuning in for this one, as we get ready to close up shop here soon on show number 23 of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill. It is, of course, the 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad Hill, Keith Salminen, coming at you solo, as I have been for the entirety of this broadcast, and how it basically seems like it's been for a hot minute with a lot of these recent editions of the Bear Raid that's dating back to the few that we did right before the summer went down, and then even though it is the second show we've done covering the 2022 fall athletic programs, and yeah, so far, kind of pretty much the same old, but Donnie Knucklehead, Tad, and Tito obviously do hope and plan to join us eventually at some point for things in the future, regardless if that's right here at the studio, if we end up ever doing this thing on location somewhere, or if, even if I have to, you know, do the whole recording audio for at least the football segments of the show and maybe getting their final thoughts up there on the hill when we're at a game, if I, you know, got to incorporate them that way, so be it. But yet again, another fine edition of this Cal-themed, Cal-fan-produced podcast brought to you by a 99-year-old pile of dirt overlooking a college football stadium in Berkeley, California, where it's just me coming at y'all for however long we end up doing the Cal Madness here on this Twitch channel. On that note, let's go ahead and get through the final segment of tonight's show and check up on the final three athletic programs that we'll be covering on this edition of the Bear Raid. Coming up first, of course, will be the golf programs over at UC Berkeley. The men's and the women's golf program. We'll go ahead and take a look at what men's golf has been up to, and they actually began play back on September the 4th, so they played the first of 2 days in the Fighting Irish Classic over at the Notre Dame Golf Course in Notre Dame, Indiana, South Bend, Indiana. I want to say I believe we did recap that, but just to be on the safe side again, on day one of that tournament, Cal ended up placing 10th in day one of the Fighting Irish Classic with 279, 283, plus two on day one. At the end of day two, which of course was on September the 5th, which was a Monday, Cal would end up finishing 10th in that one as well. So 10th overall period for the entire tournament with 279, 283, 285, plus seven. And that's it. Basically, they only had, you know, we covered one set of golf matches that day, the last time we came at you. Covering it again just to be on the safe side. And, hey, only one other time that they've played since then. They will only be playing one other time as well between now and the next time we come at you here on the Bear Raiders. Their next match that they will have take place will be an all-day fiesta for Cal Men's Golf at the Menlo Country Club in Woodside, California. The big match is Cal Men's Golf will take on Stanford Men's Golf. That, again, will be an all-day event that will go down on September the 29th at Menlo Country Club in Woodside, California. They don't play again after that until on October the 3rd, so we'll wait until, obviously, when we come at you on the 2nd to preview what they got on October the 3rd and beyond after that. So, yep, only two matches for Cal Men's Golf since last time we came at you. And again, I'm pretty sure we recapped the first day of the Fighting Irish Classic on the last show, but just figured to be on the safe side. So, yeah, two matches in, and that's pretty much it right now. As again, they ended up placing 10th in the Fighting Irish Classic back on September the 4th and September the 5th. They, again, will not be playing again until the big match against Stanford Men's Golf on Thursday, September the 29th. We'll go ahead and stick to the golf links, obviously, as we continue on here, but switch it over from men's golf to women's golf and see how the Lady Golden Bears are faring on the links so far here in the fall of 2023. They actually haven't started yet, so obviously this is kind of, I think, the first time we'll be mentioning them here on the show, I'm guessing. My bad. So actually two programs that we're going to be previewing here on the show to wrap up things, as Cal Women's Golf will begin play for the first time on September the 12th and September the 13th. Those will be Monday and Tuesdays as part of the Olympic Club Invitational at the Olympic Club over in San Francisco, California. Obviously, that event being hosted by the University of San Francisco. Again, the Olympic Club Invitational will be going down on Monday, September the 12th, and Tuesday, September the 13th, all-day affairs at the Olympic Club in San Francisco, California. After that, they will also play on Thursday, September the 29th. And just like the men's program, it will be the women's golf version of the big match, as Women's Golf will take on Stanford Women's Golf at Menlo Park as well, and that will be an all-day affair as well. So that's what's coming up. Cal Women's Golf not starting yet, but they will have played at least three or four times before we come at you here on the next edition of the Bear Raid. Finally, the final sport of the night that we will be touch bases on, and this sport actually has started already. I don't know, for some reason, I guess I thought that the women's golf had began already, or just maybe I put that on there, maybe I previewed it on the last show, kind of, you know, slipping my mind, I guess, on how things went at the tail end of that one. But Cal Men's Tennis, actually, they have not started yet. They are going to be getting ready to start up here. Wait, they did start. God, I hate when they do this. I love how these Yoo-Hoos can never put the one time where I actually pull up something on here, and they don't have what they did in those matches. So I'm going to have to hold on, bear with me here. I'm going to have to pull up the news section on things with Cal Men's Tennis. I would have figured they would have at least put something up there to show who did what and all that stuff. But yeah, anyway, Lord, you know what? We'll go ahead and we'll hold off on that. I'll just go ahead and give you all real quickly what their schedule has been. You know, God, it upsets me, because usually with all the other programs on here, they usually put who did what on that day. And, they didn't do that with, men's tennis, but, yeah, whatever. Their season started on September the 16th. Was the Battle of the Bay qualifier at the Hellman Tennis Complex. And they also had that going down yesterday, September the 17th. But it doesn't show on here, you know, what the outcomes were or any of that stuff. You know, I was trying to look in the news. Looks like one of the guys advanced in that Battle of the Bay stuff. But again, just would be nice if they actually had that intel right here on the schedule like they do with the other sports. So, yeah, I guess if we're going to be doing that, I'm going to have to actually dive a little deeper into that and actually pull those up individually and just write them down on a piece of paper. Anyway, upcoming matches for Cal Men's Tennis, September the 23rd, which is a Friday through Sunday, September the 25th, they'll be in the Battle in the Bay match, or I guess that will continue, and that will be against USF over at the California Tennis Club in San Francisco, California. Also going on that same time frame as well as the Napa Valley Invitational in Napa, California. So it looks like they'll have, you know, at least one player or a couple players playing in San Francisco, and I guess the others will be in Napa the 23rd through the 25th of September. Going down also for Cal Men's Tennis on Monday, September the 26th, through the day before the next edition of the Bear Raid is the 15K's Future, which will take place in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Looks like there will also be some Cal Men's Tennis players involved in the Aggie Invitational, which will go down on September the 30th through October the 2nd, which, of course, is when the next edition of the Bear Raid comes at y'all. And they also look like they will have some guys tied in the ITA All-American Championships, which will start on October the 1st. So, yeah, that's what that's up with men's tennis and what's going to be going down for men's tennis between now and the next time we come at you. So, yeah, man, it'd be a lot better if y'all would actually do a better job, Cal, of having all that stuff on there, which reminds me to iterate, by the way, and I forgot to mention it early in the show. Any of you out there, either if you're a Cal athletic fan or if you're a former Cal athlete that has played in any of the programs that we've covered here on the show tonight, and you feel you can do a little bit better job of breaking this stuff down than I do, because let's be real, my specialties are obviously baseball, football, some basketball, and I'm slowly starting to learn soccer, obviously, given the fact that, you know, we got the Oakland Roots, the professional team over here in the town. The other ones, you know, yeah, it's kind of a little touchy-feely and touchy-go with some of the other ones. So, yeah, any of you out there that follow those other athletic programs that we touch bases on tonight, hey, again, doesn't matter if you're a fan or if you're a former student-athlete from UC Berkeley, you want to contribute on that, we're always welcome to that. Yeah, just hit us up at the various locations where you can, of course, contact us for all that info. And I'll go ahead and pull that up right now before I do my my final thought for y'all here. Of course, as always, for more information about the Bear Raid, be sure to check things out at facebook.com/TightwadHillOfficial. Follow the Bear Raid and Tightwad Madness over on Twitter at TightwadHill23. Until we get a Tightwad Hill website relaunched again at some point in the future, you can find stuff in regards to the Bear Raid online also at AceFanRadio.com/TheBearRaid, presented by Tightwad Hill. All live Bear Raid broadcasts, unless something's otherwise is noted in regards to that. If you know what I mean by that, is obviously if we end up just doing like a YouTube exclusive for some reason or another. Outside of that, all live broadcasts of the Bear Raid will take place right here where you're watching the Bear Raid at right now, which of course is twitch.tv/AceFanRadio. And of course, all past editions of the Bear Raid you can catch over on Ace Fan Radio's YouTube channel at youtube.com/C/AceFanRadio. And of course, the next edition of the Bear Raid presented by Tightwad Hill will be, of course, coming at you on Sunday, October the 2nd. That's when show number 24 of the Bear Raid will be hitting y'all upside the heads. If it's more than just me hosting the show, it will be at its normal 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time time slot. But if it ends up being a situation again like tonight, where I'm hosting the show solo, then we will, of course, move show number 24 to the 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time slot over on twitch.tv/AceFanRadio. And, of course, for always, be sure to RSVP for that and all future Bear Raid podcasts by hitting up the event page section of facebook.com/TightwadHillOfficial. And real quickly as well, before I forget, along with some of the sports, obviously, that we talked about on tonight's edition of the show. When we, of course, come at you for the next edition of the show on October the 4th, we will have a couple more sports coming into the mix that we'll be touching bases on and what they have been up to. Those, of course, being the rugby program, women's tennis, men's swim and dive, and also women's swim and dive. So four sports programs at UC Berkeley will be joining along with the sports that we've already covered up to this point in time over the course of these first couple shows of the fall 2K22 portion of things for UC Berkeley. On that note, as always, hey, thank you all for tuning in. Nice to actually kind of get back into a regular every other week schedule with doing this, because I remember, of course, when we were wrapping up things with the spring programs, we kind of catted off a little bit, you could say, with some of those broadcasts at the end of the spring, which resulted in an unplanned version of what was going to be a summer break for the show anyway. It just ended up happening a little bit earlier than planned. Again, would be nice to be having my cast members join in here, you know, regardless if they're sitting right here with me in the studio, or maybe somehow I can convince Donnie or Taddy to start calling in. Just like I have, you know, Boss call me when I do A's Fan Radio, get one of them used to call in. But again, as I mentioned, if not, then I'll just have to resort to other means to get them in on the show somehow, some way. But again, as always, thank you to our fellow Tightwads and our fellow California Golden Bears fans for checking out this Cal fans take on recapping and covering things with all the various athletic programs that go down at the college that either some of us out there are alumni from, or if you're just like me, just basically representing love because of the fact that, hey, my grandmother got offered a scholarship there and turned it down to raise basically a family, which, you know, resulted in me being brought to the planet. But just still, even with that, the family's always basically followed Cal even before she was offered that scholarship. So, you know, again, someone like me that just happens to be a fan of the Bears, or of course, any of y'all tuning in that are alumni or even current students up there, thank y'all for tuning in, checking us out. And hey, just be sure to always catch us. Feel free to come by and say what's up to myself, Donnie, Taddy, and Tito if you happen to see us up on Tightwad Hill or in and around Berkeley, or, you know, even for those of y'all that, of course, you know, live over in the Oakland and East Bay area, you know, that run into, you know, our asses sometimes. You know, don't hesitate to say what's up. And again, as mentioned, for anyone out there that follows some of the other programs or athletic programs that we covered on the show tonight, that again, you feel like you can do a little bit better job than I did, again, don't hesitate to hit us up on Facebook or Twitter, and feel free to share your thoughts on how you can help, you know, maybe contribute to covering some of those sports a little bit better than myself, Donnie, Taddy, and Tito can, and whatnot. And again, also want to, again, thank Laval's Pizza over on the north side of Berkeley for hosting Tightwad Hill for our Cal Notre Dame watch party yesterday. Not the outcome we wanted, obviously, but again, like I said earlier in the show, winnable game. Cal screwed up, failed to capitalize. One thing I forgot to mention is probably one of the things that they should have done is instead of trying to go for that damn first down or touchdown on fourth down, they should have just kicked the field goal that would have brought them within four, tried to stop Notre Dame on defense, and then obviously try to march down the field again at that point. But I was reminded, of course, by my good friend and my A's Fan Radio co-host, the Boss Man. Probably part of the factor of what happened with that is, hey, Bill Musgrave, unfortunately, is still the offensive coordinator at Cal. And those of you, of course, that listened to A's Fan Radio back when myself and Boss gave a damn about the Raiders when they were still in Oakland before they dipped for the second time, we were not big Bill Musgrave fans. And the reality is I'm still not a big Bill Musgrave fan. But again, game yesterday, it was winnable. It wasn't. Just, hey, shake it off and you got to do what you got to do to win the homecoming game. So yeah, shake it off, Cal football, and just get yourself back on the winning ways. And of course, good luck to not just Cal football, but the other Cal athletic programs out there between now and the next time we come at you here on the Bear Raid, because we want to talk about Golden Bear victories more than Golden Bear losses here on this podcast. So yeah, best of luck to the Cal programs out there between now and the next time we come out here at y'all on the show. On that note, this is, of course, the 30th and current sitting governor of Tightwad Hill, Keith Salminen, on, of course, behalf of the rest of the cast here at the Bear Raid, signing off for the evening. Take care, all my fellow Tightwads and California Golden Bears fans, and enjoy what is left of your Sunday night. The views and opinions of our cast, our guests, and our listeners are in no way, shape, or form affiliated with the University of California, California Athletics, the Pacific 12 Conference, or the NCAA. As always, thanks again, fellow Tightwads and fellow Cal fans, for tuning in. Take care. We'll see you back here in 2 weeks for the 24th edition of the Bear Raid right here on twitch.tv/A's Fan Radio. Until then, y'all take care. Stay blue, stay gold, and of course, roll on, you Bears! Good night, everybody. Take care, and we'll see you in 2 weeks.